Oh, all right, let me get me cup of tea.
Al Reed, how you doing? Camp Cretaceous, I should say Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous. Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous has released another trailer. If you remember a while ago, there was a trailer that just showed like a Jurassic World raptor. And it was like a realistic kind of looking raptor. Are we gonna have like realistic people? And then they showed this post, which showed like the kids. And the kids are very, because it's made by DreamWorks, it's very cartoony. So it's like you've got these realistic dinosaurs, because that's what kids and people want to see, I guess. But then you've got these cartoony people, and this is my first reaction to it. So how instead of talking, let's just watch it. Go. Ooh, there it is, Camp Cretaceous.
Oh, is this not the most amazing camp you have ever seen?
This is so cool.
Ah, that's how it all starts. Then it's running and screaming. Oh, wait, whoa, whoa, whoa. Is that Ceratosaurus? Oh, my God.
Hello? Can anybody?
Camp is open. Okay. The camp is open? It sounds like it's closed. Oh, and there's Rexy. There we go. Coming to Netflix on September 18th. Oh, as well as a ducky. Oh, I look forward to that. Okay. Oh. Ah, wow. I have mixed feelings when it comes to this. Okay, let's just play it through. So, the concept looks kind of interesting. I like how we got representation for everybody now. Like, it just seems to be how things are going, which is completely fine. Dinosaurs, yeah, they look so realistic here. Wow. I mean, the models look great, but I do like, if you took, what was that? Was that a Ceratosaurus? And I think this is the problem that I'm having with it. Like, you take that screenshot and it's definitely the models that are the ILM or whatever the studio was that made them. But then you in the next shot, you've got those character models and you're like, okay, that kind of doesn't fit in. I mean, it's weird because it does in a way, but then you've got these, oh, it's Carnotaurus. It's a baby Carnotaurus. Oh, okay. It's a baby toad. Actually, I saw the top comment on this and the top comment was, great, none of these characters are gonna die or be injured. I'm therefore not interested, or like there's no suspense. I can understand where they're coming from when it comes to that, because that's what keeps you invested, right? These characters are in danger, and if you know that they're going to survive, then you don't really care. And that's the problem with Chris Pratt, and I guess with Bryce Dallas Howard, or, you know, Owen Grady and Claire, respectively, is that you know that they're going to make it out of it. You know that they're going to survive, no matter. Like, Chris Pratt was swallowed up by a friggin' pyroclastic flow and he survived. He should have been burned. He should be melted. If I was a kid and I was to see this, I'd be excited for it. It's one of these like feel good, short little animated episodes, about 20 minutes to half an hour long. But this, I don't know if it's canon. I don't know if it's supposed to take place. Actually, no, that's right. Yeah, this is supposed to happen during the events of Jurassic World, when Indominus Rex does get out in a different part of the island. Like I said, whether or not it's canon, I don't know, and I don't really care at this point. The amount of people, like the diehards, are like, oh, that's not canon, this, and even Colin Trevorrow is like, he jumps the shark and relocates things, so if he doesn't care about canon, why should I? Like, I think it's interesting that they showed this scene with, what do you call it? Oh, you've got the Indominus looks cool. It's nice to see the Indominus Rex back. But do you notice something that they always seem to, whenever it's a new kind of Jurassic thing, they come back to the island, or they come back to Indominus Rex. Not what's I mean, I guess they can't spoil what's happening in the future. But it's tried and tested. You know, everything's fine, and then dinosaurs break out. And I guess I have a feel that's what Dominion's going to be like. Everything's fine. And then, oh, wait, no. Yeah, remember the dinosaurs. And they attack. And I guess it's kind of like the formula for a disaster movie or a monster movie. So already we've got what? They're going to be swinging. They're swinging on the things like, wow, this is so cool. And then as you can see in the background, if I just like go back just a second, this thing is where I think they're swinging from. And then you get a shot with the Indominus Rex, like, obviously it chases them. And then they're kind of distressed here. These are the ones that come down afterwards, or maybe they are just distressed in general. But then you have the claws from the Indominus Rex on the thing, what it appears to be the thing. You've got a lot of like fan, or at least things that we've seen before. I don't know what you would call that, because it's not fan service, because I am a fan and I don't care for it. Like, still no sign of a Dilophosaurus. You've got the spinning gyrosphere, the Sinoceratops that knocks the gyrosphere. I mean, that looks like they're on Main Street with the raptors who are bearing... Oh no, they're in the raptor pen. So he falls into the raptor pen? When does this happen? Can't be canon, surely. You got... Just like, I guess, you know, oh, hold on, making kind of a mockery of the Zara death scene. It's like, you can have a boat, you know, paddling around in the Mosasaurus enclosure. And I'm assuming you've got the main character there. They're not going to die. Zara falls in, splashes around for a second, eaten, completely gone, dead. And then you've got the Fallen Kingdom scene with... one of the characters hanging over where the shark would do be where the shark hung, and now the Mosasaur is of Godzilla proportions. Oh, and seeing as I'm not making any revenue from this, because I'm sure either Universal or Netflix or somebody's gonna claim this video, let's watch it once more with audio. I like the Humvee kind of Mercedes 6x6.
You have ever seen?
This is so cool.
Swinging by the Brachiosaur. I mean, yeah. I was just trying to think, is that canon? But who knows at this point? Is there any more dinosaurs? Any new ones? I mean, Sino's confirmed now. That wasn't confirmed. And that's it, basically.
Hello? Can anybody...
Very Jurassic World theme there. I'm trying to see if there's any more dinosaurs that we can spot from this. I mean, the toy line is hit. There's supposed to be like a baby ankylosaur called Bumper or Bumpy or something like that. So you've got you've got realistic dinosaurs. You've got cartoony protagonists. You've got almost like a dinosaur pet called Bumper, which is very like Chomper or Bumpy, you know, from Land Before Time. I mean, it looks like they've put a lot of effort into this. I'll watch it. I will watch it, because I am kind of curious. But at the same time, I'm not going to like break it down, because I mean, unless it's terrible, unless it's really bad, which I don't think it is. And to see something else Jurassic related, how could I hate that? There's nothing here that I'm getting annoyed at. It's just kind of interesting, the art style choices going from the characters and the dinosaurs. But honestly, that's the only gripe I have with it. It looks like, you know, made for kids, but kind of like teen and anyone who's interested in the Jurassic franchise, kind of short series that documents something else that happened in the park. And it's kind of what DreamWorks have been doing, especially for the Dragon series. It was like, oh, this is in between the movies, and this kind of happened. And apart from the Lego series, we haven't had anything in between. If you could include Battle of Big Rock, but that was like a high budget thing. If Jurassic Park fans get annoyed at this, come on, man, surely your life's not that boring. you're trying to like pull drama, or like, oh, this looks rubbish, I can't believe this. Because this looks completely harmless, and I'm probably going to enjoy watching it, and there's nothing else really to say. I'm looking forward to it, and that's it. I don't know what else I can say, really. Always nice to see Indominus Rex back. That was probably, I found that dinosaur more interesting than Indoraptor. I don't know why, because Indoraptor technically had more personality. It smirked, for God's sake. it emoted more than Blummin' Indominus Rex did. Maybe we'll live stream this or do something similar. I don't know if I can do that on YouTube though. I don't think I can live stream it, but maybe on Twitch? I don't know. It's a lot of effort. But this just came to my attention, and I thought I'd give you my initial reactions to it. In short, looks good. That's pretty much it. A few of the scenes look a bit empty. Maybe that's because they're not fully rendered and they've still got lots of things to add in, possibly. But apart from that, what else can I say? Enjoy this video, guys. Leave a like, and until next time, I'll see you later. Oh, bye-bye.